Now that we have a DICOM server running with Horton, we will take the role of the service class user to send echo and store requests. The goal of the echo service is to check if a communication is possible between the user and the provider. All DICOM communications begin with an associate request, which will contain the destination with the application entity title, the host and the port, as well as the presentation context. The provider will reply by confirming the presentation context and accepting the association. Then, the user sends an echo request with a message ID to which the server can answer with the status success. Finally, a release request is made by the user and accepted by the provider to end the association. We can look at this in action using the Horton server, the DCM4SHE command line tools. The Horton DICOM server runs on port 4242. It has the application entity title Horton. We can use the StoreSCU program to send a C echo request to the DICOM server. We can follow the whole process in the terminal, starting with the associate request and acceptance, we then have the echo request and the response, which has the status 0, meaning that the operation was successful. The goal of the store service is to send a DICOM object from the user to the provider. The store service starts in the same way with an associate request and acceptance. The CStore request afterwards contains more information. It has a message ID but also a subclass UID which will tell us what type of image we are trying to store, and of course the rest of the DICOM file with the metadata and the pixel data. The request will then be processed by a server. The file will be saved to the disk and the metadata may be saved to a database. If everything is successful, the server will send the status 0 in the response and the release messages will be exchanged. We can again look at this with the command line. This time, we will have to specify a path to a DICOM file in the StoreSCU command. Let's use one of our sample files. The exchange visible on the command line is very similar to the C echo, except that the presentation context now contains another subclass, the secondary capture image storage. The associate exchange is followed by the CStore requests and response, then the release. If we refresh the Horton interface, we can now find the new patient in the list, with the anonymized study that we sent. We can navigate to the study and use the Ozymys web viewer to have a look at the image, which is now stored on the server. The next video, we'll look at the two other main SCUs, CFind and CMove.